Hello, my name is Dr. Yap. I'm the senior anesthesiologist from University Malaysia Sabah. Today, I'm going to demonstrate to you how to perform a lumbar puncture. Lumbar puncture is an invasive procedure whereby a spinal needle is inserted into the lumbar intervertebral space. Cerebral spinal fluid will be removed for investigation purposes. Indication for lumbar puncture are for diagnosis of meningitis, whether it's a bacterial or viral in origin. Secondly, is for therapeutic, whereby we insert medications such as opioid or chemotherapeutic drugs into it. Thirdly, is an adjunct to reduction of the intracranial pressure with the usage of lumbar drain into it. Contraindication for lumbar puncture includes patients with altered Glasgow coma scale, patient with a suspected raise in intracranial pressure, coagulopathy, bleeding tendencies, patient on anticoagulants and antiplatelets. So before we perform a lumbar puncture, we must make sure the indications and contraindications are present. Hi, good afternoon, sir. I'm Dr. Yap, I'm an anesthetist. I would like to perform a lumbar puncture on you. Is that okay?
Yes.
Alright, let me tell you in brief the procedure. Okay, for lumbar puncture to be done, we are suspected of you of having an acute bacterial meningitis. Alright, because of your signs and symptoms are looking towards a bacterial meningitis. However, to confirm the diagnosis of this meningitis, we need to have a lumbar puncture to be done. Now, lumbar puncture is that we insert a needle, okay, a spinal tap needle into your back, all right, into the back of yours, which I will show you later. And then prior to us inserting the needle, you put a local anesthesia onto your skin, all right. After that, you'll feel a bit numb, you won't be feeling any pain when I insert the spinal cane needle onto your back. So when we insert the spinal cane needle onto your back, there's a fluid called the cerebral spinal fluid, CSF, will come out from the needle, from the back of yours to the needle, and then we will collect it into the specimen collection bottle. This bottle containing your CSF, you will send it to the lab to be analyzed to see for any evidences of bacterial meningitis. Alright? So the complication of it includes like minimal bleeding tendencies. Alright, you will have some minimal headache after that, okay, which will be resolved after a few hours upon lying flat. Do you understand?
Yes.
Do you have any questions you want to ask me about this procedure? You are clear?
Yes.
Alright, thank you, Mr. Najib. Alright. So after we have gained the consent from the patient, okay, we make sure the patient is comfortable and sit up position. Okay. Preferably the patient should be exposed the back. Okay? From the back down to the bottom of his to see the lumbar area. So tell the patient that we will be identifying the posterior superior iliac spine. So prior to touching the patient, we must make sure that our hands are clean and we are sterile. Okay. Sorry, sir. I would like to feel for your posterior superior iliac spine. Okay. So it's a bit itchy. So usually it's around this space. Okay. So you feel for an indentation over the area. Okay, and it is midline, so it is at the L4 and L5 area. So this is the location that I will be inserting my spinal cane needle later with this. Alright, so alright, I will show you how to perform a lumbar puncture. Firstly, we must wear our gloves. Make sure it's appropriate size, and then just wear it correctly for our protection. In addition to our gloves, make sure that our spinal cane needle, usually we take 23 gauge, is present, together with some lignocaine for skin anesthesia and also the specimen containers. Of course, we don't forget some gauze or cotton wool which is soaked with the alcohol 70% to sterilize the skin prior to the procedure. So, after you have gained consent from the patient and you set up the patient in a comfortable position, patient sitting up and well exposed to the lumbar curvature, we identify the posterior superior iliac spine. Okay. So the posterior iliac spine has been identified. Okay. So after we have identified it, make sure that the spinal cord needle is carefully being removed. With the arrow pointing upwards, means that the bevel is also pointing upwards. Forewarn the patient, okay, that we are going to put in some lignocaine. Alright, Mr. Najib, you gotta put some lignocaine around the skin, you feel some pain. Okay, you put some lignocaine on the skin area. Once we are almost done, we make sure that the local anesthesia, the lignocaine is spread around the skin area of where we are going to insert our spinal cord lead. So once we have already identified, make sure that we identify again the location. Okay, alpha alpha and then tell. Alright, Mr. Najib, we are going to insert the needle on you. You feel a bit painful and discomfort. I'll do it gently. So with the spinal cord perpendicular to the intervertebral space. So usually, once you identify the space, you will see the CSF flowing out and you will see it clear and colorless. After you remove the bevel, you have to collect the CSF which is drilling out and to the container, maybe around 4 to 5 drops. Okay. So usually we depends on what type of investigation that we want, and we just collect it for adequate lab usage. After you have collected the specimen, gently remove the spinal cord needle. Okay. All right. Make sure that the bleeding is stopped. Okay. Minimal bleeding is stopped. The hematoma with the cotton wool. And then we put some elastoplast to maintain the hygiene and comfort of the patient. So Mr. Najib, we are done with the lumbar puncture. You will do fine. You will have to rest for at least 4 to 6 hours to prevent any headache. All right, thank you very much.